The globe goldfish are invading lakes and ponds.
All right, who did it? Who released their goldfish?
Anglers even capturing monster-sized fish.
Huge goldfish.
Some lakes even shutting down fishing because of goldfish infestations.
The goldfish are f***ing up our lakes, bro. Like, that's literally happening as we speak, because people buy goldfish for their kids. Their kids realize, oh, the goldfish super boring. I'm not interested. And I guess they release the goldfish into the lakes, maybe even flush it down the toilet. I don't know. But it ends up in the Great Lakes, and it is a disaster of epic proportions. So 4 years ago, CBC News reported, they did a whole national story about how goldfish, if you just release them into the wild, I guess, they just keep growing and they become massive. There are literally millions of goldfish in the Great Lakes, if not tens of millions. And that's according to a biology professor at the University of Toronto. And according to Nicholas Mandrak, who is a feral goldfish, he says that the feral goldfish population has grown dramatically over the last 20 years, mostly caused by people releasing their fish into bigger ponds. Dr. Anthony Riccardi, who teaches invasion ecology at McGill University, called this phenomenon the Free Willy syndrome, telling the Times that people believe goldfish will not cause problems in the wild because they are small and cute. But they ain't that small and cute once you put them out in the wild, because they can grow up to like 16 inches long and they eat everything up, just destroy the ecosystem.
Yeah, so they're from East Asia originally, and this gets to a problem that I don't really know how to solve, but let's talk it through. So it's an invasive species, so not natural to that environment. And then when your kid gets bored and puts it on a leg, and then it grows big, and then there's millions of them, etc. It eats up all the local algae, the plants, and sometimes the fish, and doesn't have predators because they're too large. Okay, so then they get eat. The population gets even larger. Okay, now, on the one hand, I think, well, okay, that's gonna really screw up the local ecology, and we gotta be careful on that. On the other hand, I feel like, yeah, but that's the story of this planet, where things move around and things change all the time. And if we're trying to keep every piece of ecology on planet Earth just like it was, we're never gonna make it. We're gonna fail. It's not gonna work. And it's not like things didn't move around before. Yes, not because of humans. It happens way more frequently, and there's a lot more of this stuff. But I'm not sure that we could put the genie or the goldfish back in the bottle.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. I mean, a good example of something that has made its way to the United States thanks to international trade is the spotted lanternfly. Have you heard about this?
Yeah, absolutely not, no.
So it's from China. Mm-hmm. And the spotted lanternfly is an incredibly invasive species, and it's just destroying crops all across the country.
No, those guys will get, because if you're touching people's money, then you're gonna be in trouble.
It's been a problem for several years. Mm-hmm. They have finally touched ground here in California. I actually spotted one recently. Mm-hmm. And they're disgusting.
Yeah.
They're just disgusting creatures that shouldn't be here.
The fact that they're disgusting might be bothering to the local population, but that's not gonna get them to be get rooted out. But if they're destroying the crops and costing people a lot of money, then we're gonna put a lot of effort in making sure we get that invasive species out. And so it partly depends on how invasive. And by the way, sometimes you know, this story that I love so much, where they took the wolves out of Yellowstone, and then that wound up hurting the ecology, because you needed those predators. Without the predators, the deer exploded in population and ate everything up and destroyed the park. They reintroduced the wolves, and then the park actually blossomed again.
Oh wow.
So these are all delicate balances that have developed over a long period of time, and us humans are coming in and just messing up every balance there is. But we've messed up so many different ecosystems that, again, I don't think we could fix it all. So I think just chasing after one of them and another one to try to fix it all is probably not gonna work. So probably the goldfish are here to stay in the Great Lakes. And remember, in order to fix it, somehow you'd have to get all of them. That's just impossible.
They reproduce like rabbits. Okay.
Or like goldfish.
I mean, they can reproduce like in one reproduction cycle, like produce a ton of new fish. Also, they're kind of badasses in the fact that they can tolerate all sorts of temperatures. So the New York Times reports that goldfish can tolerate a wide range of water temperatures, reach sexual maturation quickly.
Wow.
And can eat nearly anything, including algae, aquatic plants, eggs, and invertebrates. The fast-growing female goldfish, Boston noted, can also reproduce several times in one season.
Get it, girl.
I mean, I guess. Sounds exhausting. The feral goldfish is also destructive, uprooting and consuming plants that are home to native species. They help spawn harmful algal blooms by consuming the algae and expelling nutrients that promote its growth, Boston said, creating conditions that are intolerable to native fish. Now we destroy everything. Get a load of this thing. Look at this picture. Look at that thing.
Yeah. It's got a nice belly there. Yeah, I didn't know the goldfish could turn out to be these ravaging creatures. Ironically, they're supposed to bring you good luck. How Asians view goldfish and supposed to bring you good fortune.
Not for Americans.
Hadn't worked out that way for us. So, but hey, right wingers don't get any ideas like, oh, here comes China again. They did it on purpose. They're not sending their best.
No, the problem is parents. Parents are the problem.
Yes, American parents that are like, throw it in the pot.
Just
no, don't.
Get your kid a dog. They want a dog, get the dog. Okay. You'll be happier too. Get the dog. Don't get the goldfish. Goldfish, waste of time, waste of resources. No one's interested.
Okay, well, that's your salty ending to that story.
What are you gonna do with the goldfish though? You can't play with it. You can't talk to it.
You can't
tell it that it's your special little prince, as I do with my dog every day.
Oh, really? We didn't know. I didn't know what you were referring to. I'm glad you clarified. Okay, you can't eat it. What's the point?
Yeah, you don't eat your pets, okay. Regardless of what they are.